are going to keep America great.
Trump campaign is now reaching voters online.
Welcome to the Veterans for Trump online battle brief.
Thank you for joining us today.
And welcome to Women in Power Hour.
Hey everybody, good evening and welcome to Team Trump Online.
Good evening everyone and welcome to the Army for Trump Digital Boot Camp.
Charlie, thank you so much for being with us.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Team Trump Online's War Room Weekly.
You know, it's exciting to be here, first of all. I served 20 years on active duty. I retired a gunnery sergeant, as you have said.
Yesterday, Joe Biden did an interview with Bernie Sanders, similar to what we're doing right now.
In times of crisis.
And it was a conversation with a colleague. I mean, don't forget, Joe Biden was in the Senate for 30 years or whatever it is. So is Bernie. They've known each other forever. And Joe Biden is clearly on a teleprompter.
I like to close by saying, Bernie, as Jill and I told you and Jill.
You know, the people in Tennessee are so supportive of the president, and they've really appreciated the leadership that he has brought to bear.
We built the greatest economy in the world. I'll do it a second time.
It's a completely different look for a presidential campaign, but this campaign was built for this moment, being data and digitally driven since day one.
We flipped into a virtual operation within 24 hours when it took Joe Biden 4 days to set up a podium in his basement.
There's no one else in this world who could be doing what Donald Trump's doing
now. Thank you again, everybody. Stay safe,
stay healthy, and together we're on to victory.
Keep America great.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Black Voices for Trump Real Talk Online. I'm Katrina Pierson, Senior Advisor to President Trump's re-election campaign. The Advisory Board co-chair members joining us this evening are Paris Dennard, Senior Communications Advisor for the Republican National Committee, and Diamond and Silk, social media stars and hosts of Chit Chat Live, and the founders of the successful Ditch and Switch movement that urges Democrats to switch to President Trump. We thank the three of you for joining us this evening. And tonight, we're going to talk about the coronavirus relief, the fake news media, and how for over a generation, Democrats have taken Black votes for granted without having to provide any real results. Let's get started. First, the coronavirus is at the top of everyone's mind. President Trump and his task force are working day in and day out, not to only keep Americans safe and healthy, but to reopen our nation's economy. And now to our all-star panel. What do you think about the decisive actions that President Trump has taken to keep America safe? Paris, let's start with you.
Well, Katrina, thank you so much for having me on the show tonight. I'm really honored to be with you and Diamond and Silk. You know, Diamond and Silk have been pioneering working from home and doing these online engagements from the very beginning. So we're all, the whole nation's catching up to what they've been doing for so many years. And it's a real joy to be able to communicate with the people tonight. Look, at the end of the day, President Trump has taken decisive action in terms of his leadership and addressing COVID-19, especially with the Black community. We know that it disproportionately impacts the Black community. The Surgeon General Jerome Adams has talked about that extensively, as well as Dr. Birx and Dr. Fauci and the president, because we know that there's underlying health issues that impact our community greater than others. Issues like kidney disease and high blood pressure and heart disease and obesity. These are things that the coronavirus really attacks and makes it very, very difficult and hard and increases the fatality. So I'm appreciative of the fact that the administration has been monitoring this, getting the data around this, and providing the necessary resources for states like Michigan and New York and California and Louisiana to make sure that we are attacking this virus head on. But in addition to that, Katrina, I think we have to start with what the president did early on. The president took that decisive action to seal off our border to first to China and then to Europe. And then through his guidelines to slow the spread, first 15 days, and then listening to the expert extended to 30 days, we have seen the decline of fatalities. We've seen the leveling of the curve. It's because the American people are responding to what the president and this task force have put together in a very methodical and a very smart and an expert way to first keep us safe from a health standpoint, but also put us on the path to reopening the government to really focus on our economic health. And the last point is this, Katrina. I am so appreciative of the fact that this president, President Trump, has made mental health the center of his response. Mm-hmm. He's been talking about suicides and depression and people really being impacted from the social and the emotional stigma of COVID-19 and the isolation. So I appreciate him for talking about that, because we have to raise that issue, because it's hard out there for a lot of Americans. Yeah. It's very tough for Black Americans right now who, for no fault of their own, are impacted by the single moms and grandparents. It's tough. But the president has been addressing all of these issues, our physical health, our mental health, and our economic health from day one. And I appreciate him for doing that.
You know, Paris, that's absolutely right. We don't hear much talk about the mental health unless the president is talking about it. Some of the things that you mentioned, I'll just add, with domestic abuse and child abuse is increasing right now. So it's really important that we do talk about those issues. And, you know, Diamond and Silk, as the president mentioned last week, many experts believe that parts of the country either have or are nearing past the peak of the coronavirus cases. So the president is working with each and every governor to reopen the nation's economy. How important is it that we get Americans back to work?
It's very important. You know, the government cannot keep the economy running. That's not how it works. It works where we get back into society, we work, and we pay taxes into the government. That's just the way it works. We can't take a credit card, run it up, because pretty soon it's going to become declined. And guess what? We have to pay all of that back.
That's right.
So it's very important that people, you know, get back into the workforce. And listen, if I was a governor, the way I would set it up is, look, go to the counties that don't really have any cases, open those back up first, work from the inside and then work out. But it's very important, it's very imperative, leaving people quarantined and shut in their houses for long periods of time.
That's right.
Will cause sickness. It will. They already said we're disproportionately affected by this because most African Americans have diabetes, high blood pressure.
That's
well,
right.
When you leave somebody shut in their house, instead of them catching coronavirus, they're gonna catch diabetes, high blood pressure, and some may even go hungry of starvation because
that's
they don't have money coming in to buy food to go into their refrigerator.
And you know, there's a saying that if you don't work, you don't eat. I mean, that's one thing that we've learned how to do here. One thing I know about us being the land of the free and the home of the brave, we're not the home of the slaves. And what I see going on here, especially with a lot of Democrats saying they don't want you going back to work. But then how do you expect people to go out and feed their families, pay their bills? People are actually depressed because they're not used to being in a line waiting on a handout. They're used to having a hand up where they have opportunities to go out and get it for themselves, not wait on somebody to give it to them. That's just the way that the American dream have been, and that's just the way that capitalism is. Right now, this is a taste of socialism,
right?
And a lot of people do not like being locked in and told what they can and cannot do, especially with whatever little bit of money that they have. It is time for American to go back to work. We've been asked to go in so that we can flatten the curve, not stay in until the curve disappears. Okay, so it is time for America to go back out, go into society, to get back to working, and then let our president continue to guide us as to how we need to do this. We're going to do it slow, just like the sunrise. It rises slow. We're going to go out slowly, get back into society, and get this country back up and running and working.
Right.
Running and working. I think that's really the key. And you mentioned, you know, telling people what they can and can't do, where they can and can't go. And it's been truly eye-opening to see that the way that some of these Democrat governors and local officials have been abusing that power, But we do see middle-class Americans standing up for their rights because, remember, before they were considered non-essential, they were deemed deplorable. So yeah. With that, right. We're going to take a quick break. Go ahead, Diamond.
Say we have to stand up for our own rights. We cannot allow people to take our civil liberties from them, from us. The only way they can take it from us is if we give it to them.
Right.
We have to be our voice and take our power back and say no to the things that we don't want.
That's absolutely right. And Katrina, just real quick, an important point that Diamond and Silk were talking about was the fact that just a few months ago, this economy was booming.
Mm-hmm.
This
That's
economy
right.
was out of control positive, never seen the likes of it in history, especially for the Black community.
Right.
And so now, as we were experiencing record lows when it comes to unemployment and, mm-hmm. and across the board, people being off of food stamps and reducing the poverty gap, we saw incredible results because the president. And now, when you look at these Democrats, for them to stand in the way of things like extending the amount of money, the $250 billion that the president wanted for the Paycheck Protection Program
yeah.
that can help Black-owned small business owners and entrepreneurs and people who have LLCs and sole proprietors, to see Speaker Pelosi and the Democrats
mm-hmm.
be excited and cheer on the fact that the funding has run out, but
yeah.
it should not have because the president weeks ago said he wanted an extension for that. So the
That's
reason
right.
why we're in this predicament right now, when you have businesses, small business owners unable to get the resources that are there from a temporary standpoint, it's not because of leadership. It's not because the president or the administration not being focused on it. It's solely because the Democrats are stalling and blocking it because they know it's another good thing coming out of the administration. And that in and of itself is shameful. We yeah. want to get back to work. And while we're being prevented from getting back to work from a health standpoint, this stop gap measure of the Paycheck Protection Program,
mm-hmm.
the Democrats are even blocking that.
That's right.
How can we get help? How can the small business owner get help if they're blocking us from working and blocking us from getting relief right now to keep the doors
right.
open and keep people employed? It's a shame what Democrats are doing right now, and we have to hold them accountable, especially in November.
We're actually
going to talk about that a little
yeah.
later in the show. But I really want to make a note here, but this is the purpose of the Black Voices for Trump Coalition,
right.
to get this message out to the community.
100%.
So with that, we'll take a quick break and we'll be right back.
People are really looking for something. I think you have to go out and really work hard.
You've sort of become like a folk hero.
There are no better builders than we have in New York, and a big percentage of that is Black and minority folks, and I'm very proud of it.
I say to the African-American people that have to suffer, I'm gonna fix it.
The Black unemployment rate, the lowest in history.
1.3 million jobs, more than 1.3 million jobs added for African-Americans. You talk about the First Step Act, thousands of people released from jail, 90% of them being African-American.
And I wanna thank our incredible president.
Funding for historically Black colleges and universities. Opportunity zones, almost 9,000 of those in marginalized areas. This president has done more for African Americans in a matter of 2 to 3 years than any president in my lifetime.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
Thanks to President Trump, criminal justice reform gave nonviolent offenders a second chance at life and the American dream.
He has given $100 million to HBCUs for scholarships and research.
And he has done all this for us in less than one term. Imagine what he can achieve with four more years.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
Welcome back to Black Voices for Trump, Real Talk Online, and we have Diamond and Silk and Paris Dennard with us this evening. Now, let's move on to a topic that we are all too familiar with, the fake news media, which is the true enemy of the people. And at a time when our nation is uniting to defeat the coronavirus, the media seems to have set itself up as the opposition, with their goal being to smear President Trump, and they will resort to lies and misinformation to do just that. Diamond and Silk, what are some of the most egregious examples of the fake news lies over the last few weeks?
Well, when you see them calling our president a racist for protecting Americans by closing down our borders to China, mm-hmm. calling him a xenophobe when he was actually being a leader, right. that's a lie perpetuated by the fake news media. When you see them sensationalizing everything to invoke fear and panic yes. in the American people, uh-huh. that's, you know, telling lies. That's why we call them the fake news. When you see the news conferences and you see them throwing out gotcha questions, yeah. you know, if we're in this together, then why aren't we solving this together?
That's right.
Why are journalists up there throwing out gotcha questions instead of how can we solve this where we can get our economy back up and running?
That's right.
So not only is the fake news, not only are they the enemy of the people, but they are also the enemy of the truth.
That's right.
What they want to create is they want to create this narrative to keep everybody in fear.
That's
and
right.
what people have to do is you need to look at it. The one thing I love about our president when he do these press conferences, he take his messages directly to the people. And that's what we need to see. And that's exactly what we love. So when it comes to the fake news media, they're fake for a reason. They
yes.
sensationalize everything just to garner up a reaction and to keep everybody living in panic and in fear. And it's so sad.
And not only that, just blaming our president for something that happened in China. Not allowing
that sounds about right.
Exactly. Not saying to China, look, you own this, mm-hmm. you concealed this, and you didn't reveal this. You know, not holding them accountable for what happened there. Why, how are you gonna blame the United States president for something that happened in Wuhan, China, that started in Wuhan, China, something that they tried to hide from us?
And if the media, if they were really on our side
yes.
as Americans, why are they spewing China propaganda?
Why?
Think about that for a minute. That lets me know some of them must be in the tank with China.
That's right.
Why is our members of Congress, the ones that are supposed to represent Americans in these districts, spewing China propaganda?
Why?
That needs to, people need to open up their eyes
exactly.
here. So wait a minute. Mm-hmm. What are you all orchestrating and manufacturing here?
That's
you know, because if we are all in this together and this affects all of us, why are you all acting like you going along and siding with China?
Uh-huh.
And all of this here started with China. Doesn't make any sense.
Well, you know, I think it's been quite clear for quite some time that Democrats haven't represented Americans since I can remember. And Paris, you and I talk on the regular. So what are some of the examples that you've picked this week for the fake news media, which, as Diamond and Silk says, are the enemy of the truth?
The fake news media is trying to sow seeds of division amongst the American people. And what I mean by that is they're trying to create this idea that there's a discrepancy or division between science and the experts and the president. They're trying to say that Dr. Fauci is against the president against Dr. Birx. That's not true. Dr. Fauci and all the Surgeon General and the heads of the CDC and FDA, all of them have said the president continues to listen to science. The president looks at the data. The president looks at the facts. And then he takes it in and makes decisive action based upon what the experts are telling him and what the science and the data is telling him. So we cannot listen to the fake news when they try to say that the president is not listening to science or data or facts. That's not true. He is. And every step of the way, they have said that he is listening and understands it. And the other point, the fake news media is trying to show that the Democrat governors or the governors are not in alignment with this president. They're trying to create division there
yeah.
between leadership. And you can see time and time again that the president keeps showing them that the Democrat governors in California and the Democrat governor in New York, Andrew Cuomo, have continuously praised not just the president, but the entire whole of government approach, saying that they are working, saying that everything that we have needed, President Trump and the coronavirus task force has provided for us, that when we needed beds, we needed hospitals built, the Army Corps of Engineers stepped in and did that. These Democrat governors are not working against this president. The president is not working against them. He's not working against the states. He's working with them. And that's why you see the curve flattening. That's why you see the resources going to these states and these cities, because the president understands federalism and the president understands responsibility. So when the fake news media tries to say the president is not working with on both sides of the aisle, or not being bipartisan, or is not listening to science, it's 100% garbage, fake news, and we have to combat it through audiences like this, through opportunities and platforms like this. It's just not true.
But you know what, Paris? Another thing with the Democrats, like what you just said, as long as they can keep us divided, it's easier for them to control us.
Right.
That's why we can't let them divide us. It's united we stand, divided we fall. We are the United States, not the divided states.
100%.
You know, that's absolutely right. And we know that the media is the political arm for the DNC, tasked with gaslighting the American public for the Democrat Party. But sit tight, we'll be right back after this commercial break.
I'm free to hug my family. I'm free to start over. This is the greatest day of my life. My heart is just bursting with gratitude. I want to thank President Donald John Trump. Woo!
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
And welcome back to Black Voices for Trump, Real Talk Online with Diamond and Silk and Paris Dennard. And now that we all know the Democrats and their mainstream media allies have taken Black votes for granted for a very long time, we remember in 2016, President Donald Trump asked us, "What do you have to lose?" And after seeing how President Trump has delivered on his promises to the Black communities, Paris, why do Democrats still feel entitled to our votes despite their history of continually failing to uplift Black Americans?
Katrina, that's a very good question. And I think that it comes down to the point that the Democrats don't know any better. For so many years, for decades, they've just taken our vote for granted. They've accepted getting 98% of the Democrat vote, especially Black women vote. And you know what they do once the person gets in office? Absolutely nothing. They don't work for us. They don't fight for us. They do absolutely nothing. But thanks be to God, we have a candidate in 2016 named Donald Trump, who became the president of the United States of America. When everyone said he'd get 0% of the vote, he got 8%, which was better than Senator McCain and Senator Romney when they were our Republican Party nominees. The president never stopped trying to earn the vote, trying to earn the respect of the Black community, trying to earn the vote, because he respects Black people, he respects our communities, and he wants us to be able to rise and to be successful and have the American dream and to live out the values that we've had in our families for generations. He wants to create generational legacy wealth. He wants us to be successful in every aspect, whether it's education, and we've seen that with his support for HBCUs, whether it's with health issues, but we see that with his important kidney executive order, really attacking the issue of kidney disease. We've seen it with the president, with criminal justice reform, and the things that he's done to do that have been unprecedented in terms of any type of president, Republican or Democrat. We've seen from 2016 President Trump work aggressively to get the Black vote. And recently, I've seen polls that show upwards of 20%, 35% of support for President Trump amongst the Black community. And it's because of his promises made, promises kept. Democrats take our vote for granted and they do nothing for it. President Trump has never taken the vote for granted. He's never taken our people for granted. And he's continuously worked every single day, not just during the campaign, but during the presidential, not just in the campaign, but during his time as president in the administration through policy, and now in the reelection campaign, he has been showing us time and time again that he's working for us. And I'm grateful that he has people on his team like you, quite frankly, Katrina, who's been there from the very beginning in both campaigns, making sure that Black issues are on the table and that the campaign and the president is being responsive, and he is.
That's right.
Well, Donald Trump, the candidate, definitely raised the bar. And as president, keeping his promises has created a new standard of what people will expect from their leaders. And Diamond and Silk, as founders of the Ditch and Switch movement, I'm sure you have a few thoughts on your own about this topic.
Yeah. Well, yes. You know, the Democrats tend to take the Black vote for granted. because they look at Black people as a commodity, something mm-hmm. that can be bought and sold.
That's right.
That's really what it is, and sold to the highest bidder. But you know, the one thing that President Trump said back in 2016, what in the hell do you have to lose?
Uh-huh.
But if we're not careful, and if we don't vote right, and if we don't vote for him in 2020, we're going to have a hell of a lot to lose.
Uh-huh.
When you look at what's going on right now, let's look at Nancy Pelosi standing in front of her $24,000 refrigerator with a box of $12 ice cream while you have Americans lined up at food banks to get food because they cannot afford food to go into their refrigerator.
That's
look
right.
at the governor up in Michigan that will allow abortions, allow you to buy weed, allow you to buy liquor, but will not allow you to plant a seed in the ground to grow food. Why is she denying you food? This is socialism phase one.
That's
and
right.
if we're not careful, this is what we're going to see. We're going to be slaves up and through here if we're not careful and if we allow any Democrat to hold power in this country. Mm. Period. You're looking at it right now. They don't want you to go back to work. They don't care about you being disproportionately affected by COVID-19.
Uh-huh.
They could care less about how you're making it and if you're eating it.
That's right.
Shame on Nancy Pelosi. Shame on her. She represents people. She sit up in her mansion in front of a $24,000 refrigerator, and people can't even put food in their refrigerator.
Mm.
The whole thing is sick. And let me tell you what people need to do.
Tell them.
You need to look at all of this.
That's right.
Do you want socialism or do you want capitalism?
Right.
Do you want to be free or do you want to be a slave up and through here?
That's right.
If you want to be free, you better vote for Donald J. Trump or we all going to have a hell of a lot to lose.
So make sure you vote right so you won't get left.
Say that.
R-E-D, remove every Democrat. We got to keep the House. We got to take back the House, keep the Senate, and keep that White House.
That's right.
Well, Paris, you know, to Dominic Silk's point, you know, they listed out a number of things that most Black Americans are truly experiencing. It's not something they're being told. It's not something they're watching on the news. They're actually experiencing this. And when you have a state like Nancy Pelosi's state, who's actually carving out specific benefits for illegal aliens, what are Black people supposed to think? It's right now in their faces, Paris. And so I believe that the president will have more Black votes this cycle, but we need to really hit this message home. When Democrats are doing more for illegal aliens than they are for the Black citizens they represent, Paris, what is going on?
Katrina, that's a very good point. And at the end of the day, it's about priorities. And you can see through what President Trump has done throughout his campaign and throughout his presidency and the total administration, Black people, the Black community, the Black agenda has been, the Black church has been at the forefront of this president's mind. And from leadership starts from the top. And he's made it an important part of his administration, and everyone has followed suit. And that's not just the administration, that's the campaign, that is also the Republican National Committee. Everyone is on board and understands the importance of this. But when you have Democrats prioritizing illegal immigrants over a Black American citizens in their state, that is your priority. And that tells me, as if I'm a voter, that I don't matter. And if I do matter to you, I matter way down on the totem pole. We've got to have politicians, public officials, and an administration that understands that the rights and the values of Americans have to come first. And when we talk about the least of these, when we talk about those forgotten men and women of this nation, I don't care if you're in Compton, California, or you're in Kentucky, in Eastern Kentucky, we've got to have a president who is aware and in tune with America and all of America. And I'm thankful that President Trump gets it, his administration understands that, and he continues to prioritize the Black community, whether it's education, whether it's the economy, whether it's criminal justice, and it's our health, it's our mental health, it's our physical health. The president is fighting for us. The Democrats are ignoring us, and they show it through their policies. I don't care if it was Michigan's governor when she wouldn't allow that type of medicine to come in there, hydrochloroquine, and a Black Democrat state representative said, thank you, President Trump, because if it had not been for your press conference and raising this, I would be dead. That is the fact that a Democrat in Georgia, who is a lifelong state representative and a Democrat, said, because of the president's leadership and on the economy, HBCUs and the like, I have to stay a Democrat, but I am supporting Donald J. Trump in the reelection. Yeah. It's because people see the fruits of his labor. They see that he walks the walk and talks the talk. It is more than just a campaign promise. It's a reality. And that's what Democrats fail to do. We're not a priority. We are a talking point.
That's right. Can I piggyback off of that also?
Sure, absolutely. He talked about a Democrat in Georgia, an elected official who ditched and switched.
Yeah.
Sounds like his plan is working.
But also remember that it's American tax dollars that we're talking about here.
Right.
We talk about Nancy Pelosi wanting to give to refugees or illegal aliens. It's American tax dollars. Americans are in need right now because of this pandemic. And why can't our American tax dollars be used to aid Americans, not illegal aliens?
100% agree.
Well, and I think a lot of Americans are paying attention to just that, especially when they see announcements like the one coming out of California, who is specifically targeted to benefiting illegal immigrants in that state. And, you know, everyone's going to be looking upon the federal government for more and more money, when in fact, the money just simply needs to go to American citizens. That's common sense. That's why Donald Trump was elected in 2016. And that's why he'll be reelected in 2020, and plus the work of this coalition and getting the truth out.
Absolutely.
So while we're all here practicing the president's social distancing guidelines, it doesn't mean that our campaign has slowed down. In fact, we have transitioned to a fully online virtual campaign as President Trump and the rest of the team once again redefines modern campaigns. There are still so many ways to stay connected with the campaign and to join us in the fight for 4 more years of President Trump. So stay in contact. Please text us at Trump, or text Trump to 88022. If your friends or family or neighbors want to be involved to fight to reelect Donald J. Trump, please visit armyfortrump.com. That's armyfortrump.com to sign up. There are so many ways to get involved. Right now, you can attend digital TVLI trainings, host a virtual MAGA meetup, and you can also phone bank. Another great way to get involved is to join our Trump Victory Finance Committee, which is a nationwide network of volunteer fundraisers or bundlers who play a crucial role in ensuring President Trump and the Republican Party's victory in November. So join Trump Victory Finance Committee by visiting donaldjtrump.com/bundle or text bundle to 88022. And if you do, as a finance committee member, you progress in organizing donations, you can reach various fundraising goals and benchmarks that earn membership status. Rewards include invitations, exciting events, and campaign briefings to keep all of Trump bundlers in the know. Paris, any last thoughts for our audience this evening?
Yeah, I just want to end by saying thank you. Thank you to all of the people out there who have been supporting this president, supporting Black Voices for Trump. I know that we reached 30,000 plus on Instagram. That's because of grassroots leaders. That's because people are free thinkers. They are wanting the information, wanting the news, wanting not the fake news, but the truth. And I appreciate all of you. These are tough times. The single moms, the stay-at-home parents that are now there with their children, we understand it's difficult. Those people that are on the front lines, our first defenders, having to go out and still have to go to work, the grocery store, the truckers, the drivers, we appreciate you. We thank you. We honor you. We honor the dignity of work, and especially working under this tough climate. You put yourself and your families at risk, and I think it's heroic efforts that you're doing. But I appreciate also the fact that you all are coming to Black Voices for Trump and trying to get information. So thank you for sharing the information. Thank you for staying connected to us. Thank you for following us on Twitter and Facebook and listening to us through these platforms, because we're going to make a difference. The president cares about you. He cares about all of us, and he cares about this entire country. And we're going to get through this. We're going to conquer this invisible enemy. But the only way we can do it is by having the leadership for 4 more years of Donald J. Trump. And that's why I'm so proud to be working both with the RNC, but especially with Black Voices for Trump and this Trump campaign, to ensure President Trump is elected for 4 more years.
Diamond and Silk, final thoughts for the Trump train.
Listen, whether you ditched and switched, walked away, Blexit, or ran and ran like hell, We need you to vote right so you won't get left. Vote yeah. Trump 2020. Yeah.
That's right. And you know, the devil may have meant this for evil, but God is turning this around for our good. Absolutely. At the end of the day, you all, this too shall pass.
That is absolutely right. All things work to good to those who love God. So a huge thank you to our special guests, Diamond and Silk and Paris Dennard. And thanks to all of you who tuned in this evening. And stay tuned to Team Trump Online. We have virtual events every evening, 7 days a week. And until next time, stay safe and keep fighting for President Donald J. Trump.